Dear children, so let us conclude with the chapter, the third level. Yesterday I told you to go through the chapter and underline the words, few words, and look their meanings into the dictionary. Hope you must have done that. Now just see, this is your first page. On this, the first word that I have highlighted is stack. Stack means a lot of something. That means the pile or heap of anything. That is known as stack. Stack of timetables, here it is mentioned. So stack of timetables means railway timetables. Now another word is psychiatrist. Psychiatrist is of course related to the psychology. We have psychologist as well as psychiatrist. What is the difference between them? A psychiatrist is a doctor who is trained for treating the mental illness, while the psychology is, or the psychologist word or person is related to the counseling part. Then waking dream. You have heard about dreams, daydreams, but it is waking dreams. Waking dreams means an experience that we have while we are awake, but it feels similar as if we are dreaming. Means very untrue experience that we have in the situation of waking up. Now, W-A-N-D-E-R, wander. We have discussed this word earlier too. It is to roam around here and there. Refuge, we have word refugee is noun, and here refuge means shelter. Now, it is the second page. Yesterday we have already discussed about uptown, downtown, midtown. So uptown, again let me remind you that it is away from the center of the city, the area of town which is away from the center of the city. Then subway is underground way, shortcut way. Then duck word has come. Duck, boys must be aware of it. It is the batsman who does not score. It means that duck zero. And duck means to move the head downward to avoid being seen or hit. Then tunnel is there. Tunnel, you know well, it is underground passage. Avenue, we generally get confused with avenue word. Avenue is actually not a building, but it is a street, the main street of the city, which is surrounded by the building, and it has trees on both of its sides. Then suburb is the town lying immediately after the main town, that is on the village or town in the outskirts of the city. Then arched means slightly curved. The next page you may find the words angling. Angling means to taking a turn. Slanting means sloping. You have practiced slanting lines and sleeping lines in childhood. So it is slanting. Then flickering. Flickering means to keep going off and on, means being unstable. It is used in the sense of mind also. Then on next page you will find spittoons. Spittoons means the container which are used for spitting. Then glint word is there. Glint means small, very bright light. Then frond. Frown word is used in the sense of eyebrow when we look at something with worry, with stress, and we bring our eyebrows closer to each other. Here is a word, lapels. Lapels means the folded part of your blazer or coat. The front part, we see that the folded one, that collars you can say, is actually the known as lapels. Then there are few other words are there which are actually not the difficult words, but the words which you must keep in mind. The World. The World is the newspaper's name actually, and it is the newspaper which was published in olden years in New York. Then the date, you must remember that the date on which our hero Charlie, he visited the past is June 11, 1894. Then I already explained you a first day cover yesterday. Then to skin means to cheat, figured means calculated, figure is related to mathematical figures here. So this was your chapter. The two questions that you have to write in your notebook, first is, what does the third level refer to? Third level here, what does it mean? It mean the point of time or the place or the space or the person or the situation of mind, unrealistic situation of mind, that you need to write it in your own words. I'm going to correct that. Second question, the modern world is full of uncertainty, insecurity, fear, war, worry, and stress. So what are the ways to overcome them? You have to mention all the ways, including the two ways that are given here. That one, we used to imagine about the olden days, which were more comfortable, which were worryless, when we were fearless. So you can mention that. And even one hobby has been mentioned in the book, in your lesson, that is stamp collection. So through our hobbies also, we tries to escape from the present days, worries, insecurity and uncertainties and all. You need to write the answer in your own words. These two questions I'll share with in your group too. Now you must have started with your concept diaries, CDs, which you call them in other subjects. I have already given you the format of concept diary. For the composition part, we need to write the format of compositions. But as far as the poem or the chapter is concerned, this is the format of maintaining the concept diary page. First, you will write the title of the lesson or the poem. Then you will write the writer's or poet's name and short introduction of that writer or poet. Then background of the story or poem, that is on what surrounding or what basis that chapter has been written. Then theme or core value, that is that you will get when you will go through the entire chapter. The new words that you will come across along with the meanings, you need to write in your concept diaries. Do write the phrases and idioms and proverbs that you'll get in that lesson, because they are again the part of your vocabulary bank and you need to improve your vocabulary bank every day. Now your own insight review. After going through the entire lesson or the poem, what you have, what thoughts comes into your mind, how can you summarize that? That you have to write in concept diary in few sentences. So I wish you all the very best. This way we ends up with the first chapter of Vistas, the third level. Now meet you in the next video day after tomorrow with the second chapter of the same book.